Hello again. So thank you for staying tuned in. And this is the next video in which we are going to talk about how to write a paper and scientific publication. So far in the five previous videos, we have talked about a general introduction on scientific publication. We've talked about how to write methods, observations, introduction, and discussion of a paper. And in this particular video, we are going to approach how to write the bibliography of a paper. Most of the time, you or the students I find are tensed about writing a bibliography when they're writing specifically a thesis, because there are so many references to attempt. And one change in the manuscript means you have to change the bibliography all over again. Well, I will probably show you that this is the worry of the past. And in 2020, you should certainly not be bothered about such puny little things as bibliography. In this particular video, we are going to talk about why it is important to have a bibliography. We will have a word on search engines. Search engines are basically the different places where you search for references, such as the PubMed, the Google Scholar, and so many others. Then you need to conduct a literature search. We will talk a little bit more about reference styles, and we will talk about citation managers. So first of all, let's talk why we want to write a bibliography. It gives credibility to your work. It gives you authority in quoting and makes the other person believe what you are saying. It gives you precision in what you are writing, and you should actually attribute gratitude where it is due. So if somebody has done some work, it is only correct and morally appropriate on your part to give them gratitude for their work by citing or quoting their work with references. And then, of course, if you have quoted the references appropriately, it lets you out of getting trapped into plagiarism issues, because you don't want to claim somebody else's work is your own. You just want to say that X and Y did this work in so-and-so year, and this is where I'm quoting them from, right? So then reference styles. So please remember that Vancouver reference style is the most commonly used style. The others are the Harvard style, in which they put the author and the date. Then there are journal-specific styles. But once again, I would say don't bother about reference styles. It's a worry of the past. With citation managers and with reference managers, which are available today, there is no need for you to worry about the bibliography or about different journal-specific reference styles. All this can be done. The basic Vancouver structure of a reference citation is that you first have the author, the surname followed by the name, and you truncate at et al. You have the title of the article, followed by the journal, followed by the year, followed by the volume, followed by the supplement in brackets, followed by page numbers, followed by... That's how it looks like when you start writing a reference. You'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 authors, followed by et al., with the title of the manuscript, the journal, the year, the volume, the issue, the supplement, and the year and the page. So it's all very confusing. Where do you put the colon? Where do you put the semicolon? Where do you put the full stop? Where do you put the comma? Once again, there is no need to remember all this. This is a thing of the past. What we do remember now is that there are free and paid reference manager software which are easily available. The free ones are Zotero and Mendeley. The paid ones are like RefWorks and EndNote. So personally, I have been using EndNote, but you are free to use any one of them. The basic principles of using a reference manager software are the same. Use PubMed, search, identify the references that you want to use, send them to a citation manager or save them on your computer. Then you open a reference manager, you create a library, and then import the references that you have downloaded in step 2 into this reference library that you have created using the reference manager. Then you select the citation in the library, open the Microsoft Word, start writing, and insert the citation into the document at the right place. Now let me demonstrate how this is done so that you get an intuitive idea of what we are saying. So let's say this is your Word template where you start writing something, and this is how an EndNote library looks like. These are the references which I have already downloaded from the PubMed into my reference manager, which is the EndNote, and this is an EndNote library. So let's see if I am trying to quote from this reference by Ross et al., which is on changing relative prevalence of Alzheimer's disease. So let's say I say that Ross et al. Have studied, let's say, Alzheimer's disease, and they have found, let's say they found something, and here I want to quote the reference which I have identified in the citation manager on reference. So all I need to do is go into EndNote tab here and insert the citation at the selected point, insert the selected citation. So what it does, it has given the number one right there. It has created a bibliography at the bottom, and my reference is already there. Supposing I want to write in the next paragraph now, let's say I want to quote Herb Zhang et al., who have studied the prevalence of dementia. So Zhang et al. Have studied the prevalence of dementia. And I want to quote Zhang et al. Here. Again, I can just insert the selected citation here, and it will create the second citation here. After a little while, I feel this sentence should have come first. So I just shift it here, and the EndNote automatically does it here. So I can give the title references right here, maybe bold it. And that's how easy writing references is. I don't need to bother what was the year, who was the author, what was the page number. Everything comes automatically. So that, friends, is my conclusion on how to write bibliography. So we come to the end of this video, in which we have spoken about how to write the bibliography of an article. And in the next video, we will approach the conclusion, the title, and the abstract of a manuscript. Thank you for listening. Thank you for staying with me. And please stay tuned in for the next and the last video in this series on how to write a paper.